Hachette Audio presents Reset, A Leader's Guide to Work in an Age of Upheaval. Written by Johnny C. Taylor, Jr. Read by Landon Woodson.
AA. Without your dedication and smarts, there'd be no book. TDT. To the love of my life, Daddy's baby girl. Foreword. Greetings. It is my great pleasure to introduce you to Reset. It is inspiring, provocative, and full of wisdom based on lessons of life. I've known Johnny for many years. He delivers his speeches with such passion and principle. His articles produce something of real use to the reader. You can expect the same from this book. Simply put, Reset is the most effective guide to reimagining your organization at a time when we need it most. So what does Reset mean? The true intent of this book in the world of work turned upside down is to place people with care and with deliberate purpose. Reset means developing truly inclusive organizations that leverage differences for growth and innovation. It means re-examining antiquated paradigms and developing policies that support your unique company culture. It means tapping into the hidden superpowers of non-traditional talent pools. It means deepening and diversifying your talent pools and building skills with remote education and distance learning. It means that people matter more than ever. It means leaders must face the hard truth that their biggest challenge isn't technology, innovation, or even leading. It's finding, developing, and engaging the right talent to thrive now and in the future. We live in a world of constant upheaval, a concept generally understood as a period of great change and disorder, sometimes used in reference to the Earth's crust. But instead of geological shifts creating heretofore non-existent islands and lakes, Reset details in plain language the tectonic changes underway for work, workers, and workplaces, for all things work, and delivers data-driven practical guidance and solutions. Johnny has a gift for understanding what matters most in the world of work, what levers to pull, and how hard. But he is also a gifted storyteller, and perhaps Reset shines brightest in the many captivating stories that bring to life the insights and guidance of the book. In Reset, Johnny challenges, enlightens, and delights, and more than a few times, predicated on the hard truth that if leaders don't get culture right now, they won't survive the war for talent, much less thrive in the future of work, Reset shows executives how to lead through difficult, extraordinary times, gives HR professionals a deeper understanding of the urgency to cultivate culture and the agency of HR to implement real change, emboldens leaders and senior managers to harness the power of people for those not formally in HR, but charged with the success and growth of employees, and offers people managers big-picture insights and data-driven organizing principles for improving day-to-day management and achieving long-term goals. If you're a leader, active, aspiring, or otherwise, this is not just the right book at the right time. It is essential reading for building better workplaces and a better world. Ram Charan, Global CEO Advisor and Best-Selling Author. Preface. As the leader of an organization devoted to human resources, HR, I find that I'm often frustrated by how difficult it can be to convince other leaders why HR is so important. That's because, as an employee, it's actually something you feel more than you see. I've been there. Mine is an outside-in perspective. Too often, books on this subject are written by leaders who have been involved only in this profession, the lifers, whereas my career began in journalism and took incredible twists and turns before landing me where I am today. I was always a curious kid, so the idea of being a reporter seemed at first like a natural fit. So much of that job is about asking questions. I was also a driven student wanting to achieve, and fast. By age 20, I had earned a bachelor's degree with honors in journalism from the University of Miami. I landed an internship at the Miami Herald back when the newspaper industry was growing in size and influence. The Herald was one of the best papers in the country, and I enjoyed my work there. But it wasn't my passion, and I quickly discovered the real downside of journalism. It didn't pay. I decided to go to law school and earned a Doctor of Jurisprudence degree and a Master of Arts degree with honors from Drake University. Now I really was on my way. Within a few years, I became Vice President of HR at Blockbuster, which at the time was the big innovator in the home movie experience. Following that, I took on the role of a Senior Vice President at Viacom's Paramount Pictures. Then it was on to become Senior Vice President at IAC, Interactive Corp., where I worked with legendary CEO Barry Diller. After IAC, I wanted to explore the nonprofit world and had the opportunity to serve as CEO of the Thurgood Marshall College Fund for 7 years. It was an incredible honor to represent nearly 300,000 students attending publicly supported, historically Black colleges and universities, and a great experience in partnering with companies such as Apple to attract tens of millions of dollars in support of diversity. But perhaps my most important role has been that of a dad. I'm a single parent with a brilliant 11-year-old daughter who began studying Mandarin when she was 4. If you ever see me around Washington, D.C., you'll probably notice her by my side. Each of these roles I've held throughout my life and career have informed my perspective. The perspective you'll see is woven throughout this book. The Beltway is now my home, and where I've led the Society of Human Resource Management, SHRM, as its CEO since 2017. From my perspective, HR is in some ways a lot like the legal profession. People come to us to solve their problems, and every company is thrown some curveballs. It could be a corporate takeover or a shakeup in leadership. In 2008, every company faced an economic crisis the likes of which we hadn't seen since the Great Depression. And in 2020, we faced perhaps the biggest of them all, COVID-19. The pandemic was an entirely different, once-in-a-lifetime crisis. As it unfolded through the months, those of us in HR were at a loss. During past crises, we'd had a bevy of tools at our disposal, honed and tested over the years. But there was nothing in our toolkit that could address this threat to our very existence as individuals, families, and a workforce. As we witnessed, COVID-19 hit each workplace in myriad ways, and each gut punch of the pandemic landed squarely on HR. Leaders and employees turned to us for answers. Whether you're a founder, a CEO, or head of a management team, HR matters. Crises like COVID-19 simply put an exclamation point on that fact. We know from our research at SHRM that 70% of employees say they value HR more than ever after experiencing its impact during the pandemic. HR was their light in the fog, detailing safety, explaining work policy, providing life balance resources, and divining solutions to problems. And many of us were doing it on the fly. Maybe it took the COVID-19 crisis for people to get HR. Even those of us who do it for a living aren't always able to articulate the significance of our work. But let there be no mistake now. It's vital. Think of what HR has accomplished. We developed plans to keep remote employees engaged and informed, advocated for COVID-19 relief for workers, shifted resources to wellness initiatives, reimagined tools and strategies to recruit talent, and implemented flexibility plans for the workplace. And I don't mean to be too cute about this, but I can say that in many places, it took HR to get people to actually wash their hands frequently during the pandemic. Yes, HR is in all of what we do, from the boardroom to the washroom. I was reminded of this in a conversation I had with Pfizer CEO Dr. Albert Bourla earlier this year. As the vaccine rollout was ramping up in March, I talked with him about his critical position at the epicenter of the COVID-19 response. Few companies were more essential than Pfizer in determining when and how our lives and workplaces could come back to normal. The vaccine was the golden key. Through it all, from research to distribution, Dr. Bourla understood the value of HR. He said this, "I didn't need COVID to appreciate the importance of the HR professional. It's one of the most critical functions in a corporation, and I've always believed that. It's a function I get personally involved in. HR has always been important. But in this new world of flexible work, and with new opportunities and challenges, there is an opening in front of us where, professionally, HR has to define and develop new skills and processes to optimize what is expected of them. And that's to make sure the human capital of a corporation is seriously engaged and inspired and believing. It's productive to feel joy. We need to find ways to make sure that is happening. Dr. Borla's point about what we do encompasses the intangible, the emotions we associate with fulfillment, productivity, and purpose in our workplace, and how they are tied to a company's success. The way forward, that's us. COVID-19 has given a platform to the HR practitioner. I wanted to write this book because, in this moment, we have to seize the momentum not just as HR professionals, but also as CEOs and leaders. There are lessons for all of us, not only in terms of crisis management and employee welfare, but also in meeting business opportunities. This book combines decades of research and experience gained by those of us at SHRM with everything we learned in 2020. I want to detail the path ahead as a road of innovation, curiosity, and new approaches to old policies and practices. COVID-19 shook our foundation, but in doing so, it also awakened us. It sharpened our reactions, honed our resilience, broadened our vision. It brought HR into focus for all of those, including myself, who have worked hard to make clear its significance. As we embrace this reset, I'll detail how our workplaces are changing and what leaders must address to make sure their organizations thrive. HR won't be just a lifeline in the next crisis. It will be a through line for each step we take in shaping the important future of what we share as a society and as a culture. Our workplace. A note about the research for Reset. At its heart, Reset provides an inside look at how leaders lead in times of crisis and provides a playbook for reinventing an enterprise, no matter the crucible it finds itself in. A hallmark of this book is SHRM's proprietary research and evidence-based insights designed to master organizational transformation through its people. For instance, SHRM's globally recognized research has been used to inform CEO perspectives on workplace issues related to sourcing talent and Chief Human Resources Officer, CHRO, insights into the employee experience. Based upon probability-based sampling and innovative data sciences, this book presents a holistic look at organizational behavior from a practical angle. Within Reset.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.